Netanyahu himself acknowledges that there is no nuclear weapon program in Iran now. And if there is a weaponization of uranium, the IAEA will detect it immediately. Now, we can make history. We can prevent this catastrophe to happen. The attack on Iran is not a foregone conclusion. We can mobilize our forces to raise awareness, to lobby the UK House of Commons to defeat the government in the House of Commons against this catastrophic lose-lose situation and have the win-win situation. The win-win situation is to have negotiations in Iran in good faith without any preconditions for a peaceful resolution of this standoff.
Thank you very much, Abbas. Nothing will be achieved by trying to shout down speakers. What we're concerned about here is opposing an attack on Iran. Many of us on this platform and other platforms have frequently spoken out about human rights abuses and many other issues in Iran. The issue is not an attack by Western forces who will benefit in oil in exactly the same way as the Western forces have benefited from the oil of the people of Iraq. And so I'd like now to invite the convener of the Stop the War Coalition, Lindsay German, to address the meeting.
Thank you very much, Jeremy, and thank you all of you for coming here this afternoon. This is the most dangerous time we have seen in the world since 2003. Then we had the war with Iraq, which they told us was going to bring peace and democracy to the Middle East. Actually, it brought disaster for the people of Iraq. What they're now doing is trying to have a rerun of the war in Iraq. What they are saying is that they want to bomb Iran in order to stop them getting nuclear weapons. And what they're doing is exactly the same thing that they did in 2002 and 2003. What we were saying then...
Could I ask those people in the middle who are preventing others from seeing or hearing the speeches to please stop this misbehaviour now, so we can have an orderly demonstration in which people can legitimately put their points of view. Can you please listen to what Lindsay German has to say against any military intervention in Iran which will cost the lives of tens of thousands of wholly innocent people? Lindsay.
I'd like to say firstly that anybody who thinks that by being against the regime in Iran, this means you have to support a war by the Western powers, you are making the biggest mistake of your lives. What the people who didn't like Saddam Hussein said exactly the same thing, and yet there were a million dead at the end of that war. They are building up Iran in just the way that they did in Iraq. What did we have here? Since the beginning of this year, we've had an oil embargo, we've had sanctions on banks, we've had the assassination of a nuclear scientist. Those things have been carried out by Israel, the United States and the European Union. They want to bring war yet again to the Middle East. They did this. You might have thought they would have learned from the lessons of Afghanistan. You might have thought they would have learned the lessons of Iraq. But they have learned nothing. And the people who support the wars have learned nothing either. We have to oppose a war on Iran, oppose a war on Syria, because these are not about democracy. They're not about freedom. They are about spreading the power of US imperialism, the people represented in this building here. And we are here today to say no war, no imperialism. And let's... The question of the regime is a matter for the Iranian people. We here in the West have one duty, to oppose our own regime. And that is what we are doing. I just like... Sorry, I'm not religious. We have to oppose this war. Do not think that because it is a crazy thing to attack Iran, just because it's a crazy thing to do, doesn't mean that they won't do it. Therefore, we have to start now with our campaign. Please come back today and say to everybody you know, to all the people in your campaigns, to all your supporters, we oppose the war on Iran, we oppose any intervention in Syria, the so-called international community are once again banning the drone for war, and we are not going to let them do it. We are going to stand up and be counted against war, against intervention, and we start today with a campaign which will continue to mobilise until we have ended all the threats to war in the whole
Lindsay, thank you very much. Before I call the next speaker, could we give a very warm welcome to Occupy London, who are over here. Welcome to the Occupy movement. And we're going to have a speaker from that movement in the second part of the demonstration. I'd now like you to give a very warm welcome to the former chair of the Stop the War Coalition and a representative here today of Unite the Union, Andrew Murray. Andrew, welcome.
I think you're a good one.